Well, hi, church family. It's currently Wednesday, the 25th of March, probably my last day here at the Billabong Community Centre in the office. And of course, it'll be some time before we're able to meet together in person here as a whole church family. For me personally, other than Sunday mornings, I'll probably miss this room the most. This is our prayer room, prayer wall behind us with some of the prayers that our members have been writing on here in the last few months. A place of just being still in God's presence. And as the rhythms of our lives are disrupted significantly in the coming days and weeks, I pray we'll find ways to do that in different spaces and places. It's hard to know how to begin a update like this. Changes are just happening around us at such a rapid pace at the moment. And many of you are, I understand, feeling the acute effects of this pandemic on an emotional level, on a physical level, on a financial level. My heart breaks for those who have lost jobs, for those of you as well who are worried about the practical needs of your extended family members in the coming days, in the coming weeks, or even for yourself. And I'm joining with you in prayer for one another at this time. As I prepared this communication, the phrase that was on the forefront of my mind was, we're in this together, not just as humanity, because we are in this together as humanity, all of humanity, but also in the body of Christ, particularly as a body of Christ. Jesus has bound us together as one body, together that we may see no one part more important than another. Paul says that in Ephesians 4. For me, this is a great comfort. It's a great encouragement, and it's also a great challenge. The challenge to lay down what I often consider to be mine, but really belongs to God, to serve others, to serve the body. And as we do this together as a body of Christ, we then have the opportunity to reach out to others, to reach out to a hurting world that Christ has died for, in particular in a time like this. I really believe that this Sunday coming up, 29th of March, will be a special and really significant time of worship together as we pray, worship, and connect with each other at our Sunday celebration online and online only, because we won't be able to meet here. Even with the government restrictions getting stricter each and every day, our team has a concrete plan of how to utilize technology, even from our own lounge rooms, to provide a reliable and engaging Sunday celebration for all of us to connect in with together. So 10 o'clock normal time on Sunday morning at thebillabong.churchonline.org. I'll say a little bit more about that in a few minutes. But in the meantime, and most importantly, I want to share with you on behalf of our ministry team, our ministry leadership group, what we feel the Lord is saying at this time, and what our plans are for ministry as the Billabong moving forward in a time like this. First of all, how are we hearing God's whispers among the chaos? And how do we do that as a church? As a team, we started our team meeting yesterday sharing with each other scriptures, songs, images, words God has been placing on our heart in recent days. I've put a few examples in the email version of this communication from the Psalms, 2 Timothy, Isaiah, etc. Songs like God Will Make a Way, a song I've been listening to recently called Breakthrough. You can look them up. One person on our team shared a picture God had given her about of the Billabong being like a collection of water where people were coming to drink. But the water was coming not from like a place, a physical place like the Billabong Community Centre or something like that, but from within us, the Spirit of God, like water flowing, overflowing as we each individually tap into what the Spirit is doing within us. A beautiful picture of what is possible and happening in this season ahead. As you find moments of stillness with God, what we would love you to do is to share any scriptures, any songs, any encouraging words, pictures, God, places on your heart. Share them with us by email or SMS. That is SMS to the church mobile, which is on the website, and the best way to contact us by phone. Secondly, we recognize that in this time, caring for one another is one of the most important things we can do. Our team are committed to giving extra special attention in this coming season to provide care, to provide support to everyone who belongs to the Billabong family. We, along with other leaders and carers in our congregation, we as a team are going to do our very, very best just to touch base with you as much as possible, obviously mostly via phone, and to pray with you, to see if there's anything that you need, just to stay in touch and ensure that we are going okay together. We also want to provide assistance where we can for those who are struggling with technology and want to connect with the wider church family through technology, but that's a bit tricky. We, if you can, encourage you to join the private Facebook group, which we've got the link to in this email communication. And this is our primary, because this is our primary place of everybody connecting together as one large church family, for anyone to share. If you need help in any of that, we just want you to reach out to us. We'll help you if we can. Thirdly, we want to encourage each other to find moments of stillness and peace with God in the midst of this storm around us. So we're also going to use technology to provide just little things, reflections, prayers, encouragement as often as possible. So that will at first look like some daily text messages at midday with a scripture or prayer, just like we did in our recent season of prayer and fasting. And then once things settle down a little bit for us here as a team, we hope to provide things like some short devotionals, maybe in a video format. And again, please share with us anything that you feel that God impresses on your heart so that we can share these things with the wider church family and help increase the level of sharing of those things across the board. Fourthly, we recognize that in this time, in particular, our wider community is in such great need, and it's an opportunity for us to live out the vision that we have to see communities transformed by the gospel, by the love of Christ. At present, practically speaking, we simply encourage you to contact us via email or the church mobile if you have supplies, for example, that anyone might need. Also, if you just want to avail yourself to help, then what we'll be doing in the meantime is working to partner with other community organizations or stakeholders in the community just to help where we can, when we can, to do that well, to do that in an effective way that helps and doesn't hinder situations for people in the community. So if you know someone in immediate need, in the meantime, just please give us a call. We'll do what we can to help them out. Finally, what is it going to look like to gather together on Sundays as one church family? Now, some of you might be wondering, well, how is that even possible? How can we gather together on a Sunday as one church family? Let me share with you some of the testimonies that we received during following our Sunday celebration online last Sunday, where there were a few people here at the building, but about 70 to 80 people at our celebration online. Here's some of the things that people said. One person said, "We really enjoyed the service last Sunday." Another, during the celebration, said on the chat, "Given that I'm not able to leave my house at present for medical reasons, I love this. This allows me to be with you all." Somebody else said, "I'm so moved, I'm almost in tears." I think that was during the worship time. Another really cool thing was that one of our cleaners, who is actually from the Spanish-speaking church that used to meet here in the old Billabong facility, the shed, told me that he tuned in on Sunday on his phone to our celebration online, and his phone automatically translates from English to Spanish for him, so he watched the whole service with live translation to Spanish. I did not know that was even possible, if I'm honest. Sunday celebrations online, clearly they're not going to be the same as physical gatherings, but I want to encourage you to give it a try, just to have a go if you're not sure. What will happen is you will see the worship leaders, the prayer leader and the preacher at different points via a video. It's not just chatting on a type thing, but then on the right hand side, or if you're on a mobile underneath, you can type chat, like type in messages with everyone who is logged in on the chat window. And people will engage there, saying hi to each other, how are you going? And this Sunday, as well as that, our team are going to be logged on and ready to accept what's in the system is called live prayer requests. So this allows any one of you to pray or talk privately with one of our team on the private messaging system within the platform. If you message us and say, just love to talk on the phone, then we'll give you a call so we can chat to you. We have created a really short, simple guide called How to Join Sunday Celebrations Online on our website. And the link for that's in this email communication. But let us know if you have any questions or if you need someone to help you set it up, and we'll do everything we can to help you get connected. And at the celebration this Sunday, I want to share with you a message on how we, the church, can respond in a time of crisis like this, what it means to be the church in a time like this. We are putting the rest of our Life and Faith series based on the Alpha Talks. We're putting that on hold for now so that we can think prayerfully about the time, the opportunity that we are currently in and how we live through this as the body of Christ. Finally, please do stay safe. Please follow the advice provided by the government. Reach out if you or someone close to you is in need in any way, and myself and our leadership team would also really value your prayers in this time for us as we navigate through this as well and try to do what we can to support each other and the wider community. We trust that this is all in God's hands, and I want to leave you with this verse from Psalm 46 verse 10, where God says, "Be still and know that I am God." Grace and peace, friends.